Well, hello, crew, and welcome back to Space Station 13. Tonight, we're on Mining Object Row, and we are the janitor. We have two objectives: make sure the bar is spotless, and that the brig is spotless, neither of which I am going to worry about, because I don't care about cleaning the station. Sponges cannot fit in my pockets. Sponges have a few uses. Whether or not I'll get around to showing all of them is another thing. Spray bottle. I need that, but more important than that is the cleaner bottle that comes actually preloaded with space cleaner. Not nearly enough of it, unfortunately. What do I want to do? This is always my question at the beginning of a round. What do I want to do today with my life? We are a janitor, don't have a whole lot of access. Pretty much just my office, the hall, and the maintenance tunnels. And as a non-trader janitor, there's only so much I can do. But I do have a few ideas. Of course I want my boots. Anyone who doesn't take their boots as a janitor is probably crazy. Or at the very least doesn't do any type of cleaning. You have to have the signs with you. It is a regulation. All wet floors should be marked. And our trusty mop, which pretty much can never go in the backpack. Should always be in your hand, getting ready to clean something. A crowbar would be nice to have. And this place needs to be cleaned a little bit. Man on fire coming from escape. Of course, it also helps if you actually wet your mop. It's the small details that I forget. Come on down to the snip and get a haircut for only 10 credits. I happen to like my hair. Hey, a security guard. Don't know who. Think I'll take that. Now if I can get internals on, I'll have a complete bio suit. Honestly, how you clean the floor is entirely up to you. The pattern you take. Aww, a cute little bee. I guess. If bees can be cute. I still question that. Because behind any bit of fuzzy, bumbly cuteness is a horrible dagger of hatred. This thing is just a liability, by the way. I should probably just wet my mop, park it somewhere, and then come back for it occasionally. Otherwise, somebody's gonna push it out of the way and then run off with it forever. Run for your life, scientist. I gave him that one. need anything here? Let's see. I think I'll take that. It's scary enough in these hallways. Let alone being the janitor that's pretty much despised by the whole crew. For reasons I've never been able to figure out. Maybe someday I'll know. Now, can I actually remove this stuff? There has to be a way to scrape that off of the wall. Aha! There we go. I don't know if the fungus actually spreads as the round progresses. So really cleaning it serves no purpose except just to make it look better and to piss chemists off. Because now they have one less source of fungus to harvest from. Can I wet my mop in the sink? That would be cool. No. Holy crap. That's not what I was expecting. Oh dear God. It honks. I'm not gonna just flat out say what he is. I could flash him real easy and kill him. Actually, no, I couldn't because he's got the mask on. I don't really know what to think of this murderous clown here. Part of me wants to put some water on the floor there to make people slip next to him. Another part of me wants to possibly try and kill him since he did chainsaw me. And this is why I wanted a crowbar. I hate firelocks. I'm gonna be a traitor one day whose sole objective is to cut all the firelocks around the station. Plasma's about. The AI was doing a good job trying to vent it. But I think security made him open it or something. Which is a real bad call on security's behalf. And since we're back on this side of the station, let's just hide our little bucket. Again, I hate dragging that damn thing around. You can use your PDA to track down your mop and bucket if they get stolen. That's how often it happens. And you know, I'm not sure if the janitor actually serves a purpose. If, like, mopping the floors is kind of a mechanic designed to slow down things a little bit, or if it's designed just for the sole purpose of pissing people off. Because with wet floors around, people do tend to slow down, pay attention to their surroundings. I think my mop's dry, damn it. Maybe not. I like to think of it as a speed bump. You know, I might do a little bit of gambling too. Because who doesn't like a little bit of money? $300 should be more than enough. If I lose 300 credits, I'll be pretty surprised. And space drug smoke, which is just what I don't want. I think we're gonna get some anyways. Come on down, space drugs. Just missed it. Yeah, 50 credits. Who is this guy? Horace Crow. He's the barman. Thought he might have been the pit boss for a moment. I've seen those around a few times. Let's just say you don't want to see the pit boss around. And yes, I know I'm addicted to the gambling, but I am going to win a little bit of money. Again, not really sure what for. Care if we get drunk. Okay, that's too drunk. Hey, that's enough. Oh, he's only got an eye patch on, I think. I thought he had sunglasses on, so I didn't flash him. I was going to. But sometimes a disarming is, you know, more than enough. You don't... It's the levels of force that you have to think about. Do you want to start out with a gun in their face? Or would you rather just disarm them? And that's even a step up from, would you just prefer to ask them to stop? Please, please stop force feeding me vodka. My stomach can't take it. I normally just go for the disarm. More space drugs. And I am setting here at an even 300 credits. Kind of disappointing. That's after 20 attempts. If I can just break 1,000 credits right now, I'll be kind of happy. We could buy a whole bunch of Pro Puffs, maybe put some stuff in my spray bottle or in my bucket. God, and the barman just blew his brains out. How many barmen do we have? Lita Rowley? We have like 3 or 4 barmen now. I'm starting to think these machines have... Never mind. I'm gonna say maybe they got a little bit cheaper or something. I'm sure the odds are probably been edited from that, I think, first day where we had $3 million winners. There we go. Finally starting to make some money. The bar is always a party. No, don't drunkenly stumble over into the smoke, even though it's probably... When we get here? I'm gonna stumble into it anyways. But, hey, it might not actually affect me again, because I have a bio suit on. I sometimes forget that. Gas mask. Actually, I don't, because I don't have internals on. I'm an idiot. God, he just blew his brains out. The detective went broke? Insufficient money to play. That's sad. Valerie Williams steps up. Okay, I think 2 more spins and then I'm done. I had to really sit there and talk myself out of it, in my head. 1 more. Yes, 1,000 credits. Come on, $1 million. Damn. Someday I'm gonna win the mega jackpot or whatever it's called. It might just be the jackpot. When someone dies around here, you have to scavenge their corpse. And we're gonna go to chemistry, I think. Have a little look around the science area. We have now been promoted. We're a janitor. Scientist. Somebody actually trying to burn that off? Go, 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 go! Any O2 tanks in here? So before I go into a room that produces toxic gas and explosions randomly, I need to get my internals turned on. Here's the bomb-making room, if we wanted to do some research there, which we might. It's been a long time since I've made bombs. Part of me worries I would make one and accidentally blow it up on the station somehow. And whenever I'm a traitor, I don't really want to stand around and do a whole bunch of testing, because you only have so much time. There's not an internals tank anywhere. And of course the fire lock is down. Because chemistry is again always exploding, burning something. Gas mask, needles, droppers. Droppers are nice, but they take time. You can't just walk up to somebody and instantly drop whatever chemical you've got in it on them. If I was good at math, I would do some telescience for you guys, but I suck at math. Is that a frequency headset? Wait. Okay. For a second, I thought those flashlights were something. What's going on here? Here we go. Good job, Borg. It's always nice when you see a motivated Borg like that step up and just take charge. Happens so rarely. Let's see. This and this. And I really want to see if I can just randomly stumble across something. Set that to 1. Kind of mess with this a bit. Just scan it. No atmosphere. Z, the X and Z are invalid, okay. X and Z still. Try this a multiple of 5. Keep that a multiple of 5. And what is the Borg doing? Is it actually sealing this off? I think it is. Okay, so that's valid. That's a valid Z level at least. This is just the idiot's method for telescience. I probably shouldn't be hitting receive so often. But I want to keep making sure that these coordinates are valid. I didn't want to send, damn it. Here we go. Unknown interference prevents teleportation from that location. Can I open a portal there? No. Can't do anything with it. So what the hell is that place? It can't be that entire Z level. It's gotta be just one little building that I bumped into. If I could hit, like, the edge of it, that might work better. No atmosphere. I'm gonna step through and see what's over here. Got my internals on, cleaner bottle. Actually, what I need now, real quick, is this. Just in case I end up floating away. Oh, it's mining. Okay, well that's not really where I want to be. That's the wrong Z level. Let's close that portal. Oh cool, the next Z level even has something. Begins to glow a bright green. Interesting. Who is this? Samuel Rowe. Oh my goodness. And a killer tomato steps through. Samuel Rowe screams for help. Why can I not hit this thing? This is probably going to kill me. Why can't I pull him? Will this actually work? He's gonna end up dying here. I can't do it. Sorry, Sam, it won't work. Pretty sure I'm gonna die here. AI, hit receive on the telescience portal. Hopefully it'll beam me back. I didn't think that this would still be the mining Z level. So maybe the Z value is not what I think it is. I'm guessing that they fixed that. You cannot now pull people into a wall with you. Which is good. Science is dangerous when you don't know what you're doing, folks. I'm just gonna slur that shit out, aren't I? And no one is ever gonna be able to understand my ass. Die out here. Warning, Martian warriors somewhere. They're at escape, apparently. I'm gonna keep asking this until someone does it. It makes me sad that you can still see Borgs getting knocked out, but people never go, ugh, or anything anymore. Maybe it was a dead giveaway for something bad going on. It was probably removed for a reason. And if Ric Flair says the captain's a prick, he probably is. I'm basically speaking Martian. I'm trying to parlay with them and negotiate a truce. Can I hit receive from here? That would be fancy. I think everybody is just completely focused on either their jobs or on the Martian warriors that escape. They're already asking to have the shuttle called. Gotta be joking. Too early for the shuttle to be called. We're just gonna sit here and chill on the asteroid for a bit. And enjoy the music. IHF-1340. I wonder if that's a Borg. And I just drunkenly stumbled down. Well, time to go, never mind. I did not want to throw that. I've just fucked myself. I thought I was toggling the safety off. I don't want to die. Where the hell is the entrance to this place? Maybe the vodka is helping keep me warm? Don't tell me this is gonna be a dead end. Oh, you fuckers. Next up is going to be my spray bottle. If I knew I was going to stay this warm, I would have grabbed my fire extinguisher. Come on, there has to be something here at the scaffolding. There we go. The big freeze is coming on. That's probably more walling. Is this the entrance? It is. Okay. Well, Martian, I guess I'm here to live with you forever now. We pull out a laser gun. Okay, well, maybe we're gonna explore this place. Mr. Beepski is here? I need a way to heal. No! Beepski? I don't think so. I really didn't want to waste 2 shots on that bastard. Ooh, an obsolete spacesuit. We're gonna have to jump into that. I'm dying and I don't know exactly why. Maybe one of these will heal me. There are healing artifacts. I don't think either of those are gonna do it. Okay. Abandoned crate. Just one of them. And a dented crate. Oh yeah. Of course I'm gonna be way too damaged for food to help me. I need this to be a medical crate, and I'm gonna have to use all 3 attempts to try and open it. Okay, we're gonna start with 3, 4. Oh, there we go. And there's a cat? I don't want a cat. A cat can't help me. Just got trolled by a treasure crate. We got cannabis seeds and salmon. No way to plant the seeds. And you don't sell anything useful, do you? Kleptar. Nope. Well, we can't go back out to space. Let me see what's in these holes, too. Who knows, maybe I can get lucky and pull out a med kit. Nothing. Just alien Gibbs. Come on, lucky, nothing. Anything? We grab a skull, which I will keep. This is where things are about to get serious. I'm slow, I'm limping, I'm almost dead. And hey, there are medkits here. Hey, somebody in a space suit has shown up too. Who is that? It's Kira. Save me. So if Kira's here, she must have brought a pod. However, we're not going to go back with Kira. I really do want to explore this place and see what's at the end of it. Fuck you, chair. I'm not stepping into there. Hey, 2 more abandoned crates. I'm not gonna risk opening these with 3 attempts. Because I would like to see what's through the rest of this ship. Stand up! The chair couldn't have tripped you that bad. What? Got Spooky Dan's burritos. Bunch of alcohol. I don't want your damn burrito. I feel invigorated and guilty. Half tempted to shoot Kira right now. I hate you so much right now. Let me see, I'm gonna stun Kira and then steal her pod if I can get over there. If I'm not too fucked up. I wasn't going to, but the situation has changed now that I'm fucked up on drugs and burritos. It would be fun to take on the Martians like this. But I don't think it's a challenge that I'm up to. Kira, come back. I need to stun you and take your stuff. Hell, the escape shuttle is about ready to arrive. I wouldn't have time to get through here anyways. Nope, and Kira's already gone. Fuck you, Kira. I will remember this. Let's just run through this. Right here. Space suit. Has somebody already been through here? No. Don't hit the floor. Shoot the Martian. So I can't fire into the blackness. I can't shoot one tile ahead of me. Shoot the fucking gun already! God damn. And I am hit by what, my own laser? Probably. It's ridiculous. It's just too laggy to do any of this right now. Great, there's Martians down there. Fucking lag. Well, this was an unsuccessful spacewalk. Another one. Good, you can all die here with me. Have I fallen over? Am I stuck somewhere? It's like I can see something on the edge of the screen here, an organic wall, but I can't get over to it. Closer, there we go. I just need to stumble to the first aid kits and save myself. Uh, That's me. Rusty airlock. Maybe that's what I need to go through. Still stumbling backwards, either from being drunk or from blood loss. Quit stumbling down, you bastard. You're gonna die. I refuse to succumb and actually die here. I survived too much to get to this point. If I could just walk up. I keep stumbling backwards like I've become even more drunk. Wrong way. It's not gonna happen in 20 seconds. So I keep stumbling down. Quit stumbling back the way I just came from. Oh well. I really wanted to at least get myself out of critical. Bunch of bastards this shift. I was close. I think I managed to make it right here before drunkenly falling backwards and trying to get my ass killed over here. Not a bad little shift. I got to do a bunch of stuff. Somehow made it from being a janitor to being dead on a Martian station. Someday we'll make it through this place. Just don't know when. Maybe next shift.
You wanna put a banging